So in the last video, we discovered how you can use the game Tennis to get to glitched levels in Super Mario Bros. If you haven't seen that video yet, I highly suggest watching that video first. In this video, we'll see why the glitch levels we see can be weird versions of levels that are normally found in the game. Just like level 9-1 here being level 6-2, but underwater. There are 34 unique levels in Super Mario Bros. Well, there are 32 levels, but a lot of them are duplicates. Like for example, level 5-3 is just level 1-3, but there's bullet bills flying around and the platforms are shorter. There's a flag in the game that can convert a level into a harder version of itself, so for our purposes here, these are considered the same level. This leaves us with 27 unique levels. Then you have the two cloud bonus rooms, the warp zone in 4-2, the water room in 8-4, and the water room used in both 5-2 and 6-2. And then finally, the cutscene room that plays before underground and water levels, as well as the underground bonus rooms, which are actually all located in the same level. Each of the 34 levels is assigned a unique ID of sorts. But if you think the ID numbers are simply just 0 through 33, you are sorely mistaken. See, the ID for each level also encodes what kind of level it is. There are four types of levels: overworld, underground, castle, and water. Each of the levels is organized into these four groups, and then numbers are assigned within each group. Water levels have numbers 0 through 2, overworld levels have numbers 0 through 21, underground levels have numbers 0 through 2, and castle levels have numbers 0 through 5. The overall ID of a level is made up of 7 bits. The lower 5 bits are the level number within the sublist, and the next 2 bits are the level type, where water is 00, overworld is 01, underground is 10, and castle is 11. This means that the ID of a level can range anywhere from 0 to hex 7F, although most IDs aren't used. We can organize them in a nice table like this. For water levels, the type bits are 00, so the overall IDs are 0 through 2. For overworld levels, the type bits are 01, so the IDs go from hex 20 to 35. For underground levels, the bits are 10, and the IDs go from hex 40 to 42. And for castle levels, the bits are 11, so the IDs go from hex 60 to 65. So an interesting question would be, what about all those other IDs that aren't assigned to levels? What do they do? To answer this, we have to look at how the level pointers are stored in the game's ROM. There are actually four separate pointer lists, two for all of the level's tile data, and two for all the level's enemy and sprite data. The level pointers are 16-bit values, and to simplify the code needed to read data from these tables, the upper 8 bits are stored in one list, while the lower 8 bits are stored in another list. This way, if you want, say, the 13th pointer in the list, you take the 13th byte in each list and concatenate them together to get a 16-bit pointer. In the table of IDs we made, there are gaps in between the different types of levels. However, the pointers to the level data are stored in one contiguous chunk. For the sprite data, all of the castle levels come first and have indices 0 to 5. Then the overworld levels in order 6 to 27. Then the underground levels 28 to 30. And finally the water levels 31 to 33. For the tile data though, all of the water levels come first with indices 0 to 2, then the overworld levels 3 to 24, then the underground levels 25 to 27, followed by the castle levels 28 to 33. Who knows why they're stored in a different order, because it just makes things more complicated and nuanced. In order to easily access each of the different types of levels, there are also two smaller tables that indicate the offsets at which each of the different types start in this list, in the order of water, overworld, underground, and castle. Think of this as sort of a table of contents. It's just like a page at the start of a book that tells you where each chapter starts. So for the sprite data, this table is just hex 1F, 6, 1C, 0. Remember, all of the indices mentioned in this video are zero-based, so water levels start at index 31, or hex 1F, overworld levels start at index 6, underground levels start at index 28, or hex 1C, and castle levels at index 0. And the table for the tile data is just hex 0, 3, 19, 1C. In order to find a certain level in this list, we take its level number and add it to the index that corresponds to the level's type. For example, level 6-2 has ID hex 23, which corresponds to overworld level number 3. For the tile data, overworld levels start at index 3, so we add that to 3 to get 6, so the tile data is the 7th entry in this list. And for the sprite data, overworld levels start at index 6, so we add that to 3 to get 9, and the sprite data is the 10th entry in this list. So now we can see what would happen if we were to try to load, say, the level with ID hex 43. This corresponds to underground level number 3. And of course, there is no underground level number 3, but the calculation is still performed. For tile data, underground levels start at index 25, so we add 3 to that to get 28, and we find the 29th entry in the list is the tile data for level 1-4. And for sprite data, underground levels start at index 28, so we add 3 to that to get 31, and we find the 32nd entry in this list is the sprite data for the water sublevel found in level 5-2. This means we will end up with a Frankenstein level that is level 1-4, but with an underground theme, with the bloopers and platforms from that water sublevel all mixed together. Which is exactly what we get when we force the game to load in the level with ID hex 43. Since there are only 34 entries in these lists, if we ever end up with an index of 34 or higher, we start to read things that aren't pointers to level data. This is what causes glitch levels to appear, which we'll see happen in a bit. But knowing all this, we can fill out the rest of the table we made to see what levels will get loaded for the level IDs that aren't assigned to anything. Since the level data is stored in a different order for sprites versus tile data, levels with these unused IDs are either a mix of two different levels, a normal level layout with glitched sprites, a glitched level layout with normal sprites, or both glitched tile data and sprite data. But how does the game even try to load a glitched level ID in the first place? In order for the game to know what levels are in which worlds, and what order they go in, there is a single table that holds the ID of each level in the order that they are played. So for example, starting with World 1, Level 1-1 is an overworld level, so it has type bit 01. It has the level number of 5, so this is what its ID looks like, which is 25 in hexadecimal. This is the first byte in the table. Here is the rest of the table, which corresponds to each of the other levels. If I split them up per world, you can see that some worlds actually have 5 levels. This is because the cutscene room that plays before the underground and water levels is actually considered its own level, which was probably done so that if you die in one of these levels, you don't have to watch the cutscene again. Since each world can have a different number of levels in it, it would be nice to have some pointers into this table that tell you where each of the worlds start. Just like another table of contents, like before with the level data pointers. Here, there are 8 bytes in ROM directly before this table, which are the indices of the first levels of each world. So, World 1 has index 0, World 2 has index 5, and so on. So let's do a small example to try to get the pointers to the level data for the first level in World 3. World 3 would correspond to an index of 2 into this first table, or the third entry, which is 10, hex A. So we use this index 10 to find the 11th entry into the level ID table, which looks like it's hex 24. According to our big table, the level with ID hex 24 is level 3-1, but let's see how the level data pointers are created. Expand that ID out into binary, and we can see that this level uses 01 as its type, so it's an overworld level, and it's number 4. First, let's find the sprite data. The two bits for the level type are actually used as the index into the smaller table we made for the level data type groups. Our bits are 01, so we use index 1, or the second entry in this table, which is 6. Then we add that with the level number we got, so 6 plus 4 is 10. So we use this index 10 to find the 11th entry in the level table, which is the address hex 9ED0, which is what we would expect for level 3-1. We can do the same for the tile data. We use type index 1 again to get the second entry in this table, which is 3. Add the level number 4 to 3 to get 7, and use index 7 to get the 8th level in the table, which is hex A619, the pointer to level 3-1 again. The way you can tell something weird is going to happen when you try to load something like World 9 is by looking at the very first table of indices we made at the start. We only accounted for 8 worlds, so this table is only 8 bytes long. If we tried to find the 9th entry in this table, we'd overflow the table. Before going all in with World 9, let's see what happens when we tried to load World G. World G is equivalent to World 16. If we try to find the 16th entry in this table, we go past the bounds of the table by 8 bytes. Remember, these two tables are right next to each other in the ROM, so we just keep cruising to find the index we need. Index 15 of the first table overflows into the second table by 8 bytes, so we get this index 1 that normally corresponds to level 2-2. However, in this context, it is instead being treated as an index into the very table that it's part of. So now we use index 1 to find the second entry in this table, which is this hex 29. This is the cutscene level that leads into level 1-2. And sure enough, if we try to play level G-1, we get the cutscene into level 1-2, though it is still called level G-1. Now let's see what happens if we try to load in World 9. So the 9th entry into this table, we overflow by 1 byte, so our index is this hex 25. We use this index hex 25, or decimal 37, to find the 38th entry into this table of level IDs. But this table is only 36 bytes long. So we overflow this table as well by 2 bytes. The next thing in ROM is this small table for the offsets for the enemy data table. The second entry here is 6, so that is the level ID we are going to load. If we take a quick look at our big table again, we can see that we will end up with the water version of level 6-2. But again, let's see why exactly that is. We expand this ID into binary. The type bits are 00, so this is a water level, and the level number is 6. This means we are going to load in water level number 6, which is interesting because there are only 3 water levels. According to this table we made, the tile data for water level number 6 is the same tile data as the original 6-2, and the sprite data is loaded from some glitched pointer. This is because if we take the level number 6 and add it to the offset for water levels in the sprite data pointer list, we get an index of 37, which is greater than 33. The glitched pointer we get from this invalid index is actually hex 1C9D, which corresponds to system RAM rather than ROM. This is why glitched levels can be very volatile and possibly crash the game, not only because it is possible to load in enemies with invalid IDs, but also because the level data can be changing while the game is playing. If you play around in level 9-1 a lot, you will start to notice that the game will crash somewhat frequently and in a different spot every time. So if you can load errant enemy data, can you load errant level tile data and get some fun glitch levels to explore? We'll save that for the final video of this 3-part mini-series on Super Mario Bros. Glitched levels. In the next video, we'll look at those glitch levels you can get to, as well as the level format in general. Thank you for watching.